there. I think each and every one of us, including you guys, all of us should be. It's part of the continuing dialogue that we have with God. Part of the continual prayer that we have with God. And it's part of the working God in our minds and renewing our minds that the Bible encourages us to do. That is essential in the life of a Christian. Kind of picking up where I left off. I mean, I don't really expect you guys to go, oh, you know what, my life is terrible and everything stinks and it's really rotten right now. But you know, how's your relationship with Christ? I mean, consider that carefully in your heart. Really, how is it? And consider that next time one of your friends comes up to you and says, hey, you know, how's it going? Then I think it plays off, and I'm not going to get I can chase a rabbit pretty as good as the next guy. Chasing rabbits means I go off on a tangent with an idea. But I think it's easy. The world expects us to really, everything's supposed to be okay all the time. The world hates it down. Look, again, nobody wants everybody's stuff dumped on all the time. Somebody who's always dumping their whole load, they want you to carry their burden with them all the time. They're just totally dumping on you all. There's a problem with that relationship, definitely. However, consider the next time that you go up to someone and you say, well, and I mean your brothers and sisters in Christ, this certainly applies to the lost. Well, how are you? Well, and Garrett, again, this is something that we were just talking about last week. And I'll tell you guys, I'll kind of pick up on that if I may, since Casey missed it. I really, really, and it's kind of pick up, it's really a continuation of where I was the last time. I really, really, I promise you guys, I did not expect at my age, when I started my company years ago, when I started in the business that I was in years ago, and when we had a 5-year plan to be where I am now, it's easy to get angry at God. It's easy to stomp your feet and say, well, doggone it. You know, it's easy to run out, essentially run out of your faith. It's easy to say, well, and stomp all over your faith and say, why God haven't you done? When God's saying, well, trust me in the hard times and the good. And the person that comes to you and the person that you talk to, you say, well, how are things going? And the answer is always supposed to be, man, things are great. I got it going on. I've got, no, seriously, the adults can vouch for this, and you guys might see it on a small level when y'all, the adults can vouch. There's guys who are, and for the most part, most adults really do. You know, oh, things are good, you know, but there's some guys who are like, man, they've always had that, oh yeah, man, well, I've got this angle, and that angle, and I'm working on this, and I got this, and I'm working on this, and you're going, and you hear it every time, because everything's supposed to be moving and going for you, right? Yes? And sometimes, again, and this is even not my message, so I'm not really off base, but I just really wish somebody would come up, you know what, man? Exactly those things I talked about before. Things just really, I'll be honest, I almost feel like I'm lost. I can relate to them. Why parents say, why did my kids turn out? Or why did my job, or you guys, why didn't I why didn't y'all make it great? Or what? All these things are going on. We're called together as a church body and as Christians in fellowship again and again to encourage one another and to strengthen one another. Not that Garrett, I'm going to lean on Garrett and say, yeah, he's going to carry my burdens, but that we're brothers and sisters in Christ and we can encourage one another with God's word and say, listen, you might have a word, you might have a word from Scripture, you might have something that you just studied, but you can say, listen, man, I understand that you're going through these things, but God tells us He will provide. That this is not the end of the road for whatever you're going through, because He's provided already. So I just want y'all to think about that. It's easy to get sort of caught up in the worldly way of, hey man, everything's great, man. I got it going on. Because if you're like me, it's not always that way. I understand the urge, and you don't want to dump on people, but, you know, sometimes you need to open up to a friend or a close friend, and just, you know, a Christian brother or sister, and help you. Today, in tying in with that, I want to talk about the heart of a Christian. If you guys have ever really, really considered what is in my heart, and does it matter one bit, of course we can answer that question. Yes, I promise. So what is a heart of a Christian like? Brett, do you have that? I want to start off with just a little. Because the Bible has a whole lot to say about the breadth and put a scripture upon it.
One.
About the heart of a Christian. And Ecclesiastes is one of these books that some guys think it was written by Solomon. Most scholars think it was written by Solomon. Maybe it wasn't. But in either case, it's part of the scripture is regarded as part of the canon. Has anyone studied Ecclesiastes in the lake? Other than my boys, who I'm repeatedly encouraged to study Ecclesiastes. It's one of these books in the Bible that like has evolved. A lot of people kind of like Revelation. It seems to be saying 100 different things, and it's hard to get your head around. I'm not going to get into a lot of that. I'm going to kind of keep it simple here, but guard your steps when you go to the house of God. Go near to listen rather than to offer a sacrifice of fools. You do not know what they do wrong. Aspire to your way. Right, God, thank you for your word. I pray that you would open hearts. God, that we would have guarded our steps before we came in here. God, that we know that you lay us bare. And there's nothing that we can hide. That we can't come in here thinking that we can display the good Christian, the religious soul, without all the other things that you demand of us, that you command of us as Christians. Lord, I pray that we would understand how much you love us, how much you give it. Just like all the person. Anybody thoughts on this here? Guard your steps when you go to the house of God. Anyway, guard your steps when you go to the house of God. watch out where I'm walking. What? Huh? Yes? Oh, you need to be better. Alright. Doc Henry, don't fall asleep on me. Man, see, Doc Henry's probably been slaving away till like 4 in the morning last night with some very fortunate patients to have him under the memory's care. Any thoughts on guard your steps? I mean, I'm not playing this just as a oh, I really want y'all to dial in here. And then right after that it says, go near to listen rather than to offer sacrifice of fools. Do you think that the go near to listen has anything to do with guarding your steps? Do you think that maybe what God's telling us here, and I repeatedly say that to y'all, God's word, breathe through his prophets, breathe through the apostles. Just like he would speak, spoken to him. God speaking. Guard your step. Guard your steps when you go to my house. And come to listen rather than offer some sacrifice to me. Why does he say sacrifice of fools? Anyone? Come on. He says money's not. Let me give you a little context here. I'm going to give you just a touch of context here. In the days of Solomon, in the days of ancient Judaism, if you will, the Israelites, and these guys, they were given a whole list of instructions about how to come, about how essentially they would pay for the sins that they had committed. We all remember that the Bible is a book about God. It's a Bible from beginning to end about Jesus Christ and redemption from between redemption, redeeming us to him. Yes? It used to be a time where the sacrifices were given. And when were those sacrifices given? Does anyone? They were given every day, were they not? Every day, right? Yes? Oh, continuously. Jeff, did you have something to add to that?
I was going to say it was the Sabbath.
What Sabbath? Yes. Well, most certainly.